Hello friends, today I'll talk on paint pollution. Friends, we all use paint for beautification of our house. We paint wall, windows, doors and railing, etc. But do you know this paint can cause lots of harmful effects in our body? Today I'll talk on that. I'll try to tell you very short way and I'll tell you the most important points. So let's start. Paint has few components. Main component is pigment, which gives color to the paint. The prime pigment is titanium oxide, and other pigments are also there, like red and yellow pigment, which contain iron oxide. Some paint also contain formaldehyde, arsenic, etc. Next is solvent, then resin or holder, which carries the paint. Additives are also added in paint to ease the brushing. These are all components of paint. These all components can cause side effects or harmful effects, you can say, like headache, eye irritation, skin irritation, asthma, decreased lung function, lung cancer. According to WHO, 20 to 40% increased risk of cancer, particularly lung cancer, in case of patient who are in continuous exposure of paint. They are exposed to paint or titanium oxide regularly in factories, or they are paint workers. In that case, there is increased risk of cancer, particularly lung cancer. Now I'll tell you three main components of paint which cause lots of harmful effects in our body. First one is volatile compound. Volatile compounds, they are actually added to the paint. They evaporate after application of the paint and the solid thing remain on the wall. This volatile compound, in presence of nitric oxide and sunlight, it produces ozone, and ozone has few harmful effects on our body. I have already discussed that in my another video. Please go through that. Then next is lead. You all know lead is a metal and it is very harmful to the body. It is very much poisonous to the children. Usually what happens in red and pink primer, there are plenty of lead. After application on door, window or railing, it stays like that. But if you disturb that paint, or sometimes children chew it, or they disturb, they scratch the paint, then this lead come out, and there can be accidental poisoning of children, even also adult. So lead is harmful, and be careful before disturbing any paint or primer surface. Next is titanium oxide. It is the prime pigment of paint. It is also called white pigment. This is the white component of the paint. This is odorless and insoluble in water. This is used not only in paint. Titanium oxide is also used for food coloring and for sunscreen. Few international companies, they used to use this titanium oxide in sunscreen and food coloring, but after a lot of things came out on research, they have stopped using titanium oxide. International research on cancer has declared that this titanium oxide is responsible for lung cancer. Next is NIOSH, National Institute of Occupational Safety and Health. It has decided the level of titanium oxide. The level should be, fine titanium oxide level should be less than 2.4 milligram per cubic millimeter, and the ultra fine TiO2 titanium oxide level should be less than 0.3 milligram per cubic millimeter. And the working hour of a labor or of a factory worker who work with titanium oxide factory, it should be less than 10 hours per day and 40 hours per week. This titanium oxide is also associated with yellow nail syndrome, which is a disease in human being. So that's all about paint pollution in short. I hope you have liked this video. If you have liked it, please subscribe my channel, and thank you for watching this video.